Namaste. In this session, we'll discuss module 4, that is stresses in rigid pavements. So in this module, we are going to dealing with the different types of stresses in rigid pavements and how they are occurring and how they are acting on the slab, and so what are the formulas given by different researchers. And we are analyzing those stresses. So first one, the stresses in rigid pavement. So in that types of stresses, different types of stresses are developed in CC pavements. The major types of stresses in CC pavements consist of, so first one is wheel load stresses. So that is caused by heavy wheel loads of vehicles. And second one, warping stresses caused by, you can see here, warping stresses caused by temperature differential between the top and bottom of the pavement. So due to daily variation in temperature. So other factors which cause additional stresses in CC pavements are due to seasonal variation in temperature. So resulting in overall expansion and contraction of the slab. So that causes frictional stress. So as the frictional force resists the slab movement. And second one is that due to volumetric changes. So volumetric changes, that includes settlement of the subgrade or supporting layers. So which result in non-uniform support or lack of support to the CC pavement slab at a certain locations or stresses. So it is possible to determine stresses developed due to wheel loads, warping and contraction of the CC slab as given in the subsequent paragraphs. So however, it is not possible to estimate the magnitude of stresses as a result of volumetric changes in subgrade discourse or due to non-uniform or lack of support as a result of localized settlements of the subgrade. So as they uncertain set of factors caused mainly due to deficiency during the construction or maintenance of the road stretch. Okay, first we will see the basic concepts in analyzing stresses in rigid pavements. So in that first one is a Westergaard's analysis. Okay, so about Westergaard's analysis, H.M. Westergaard is considered the pioneer in providing the rational approach to the analysis of stresses in rigid pavements. So Westergaard is in a theoretical analysis considered the rigid pavement slab to be a thin elastic plate resting on a soil subgrade. So which is assumed as a dense liquid. So I think you have seen the concrete slabs. So thus it is assumed that subgrade provides an upward reaction. So that is P, which is directly proportional to the deflection delta. Here you can see P by delta. So that is equal to K. So constant K. Here the constant K is defined as modulus of subgrade reaction. The unit of K is kg per cm cube, centimeter cube. So that is given by pressure in terms of kg per cm square per centimeter deflection, per centimeter deflection. So equations for determination of stresses in rigid pavement were expressed by Westergaard using properties of here you can modulus of subgrade reaction is K is proportional to the displacement, that is delta, the displacement level of delta is taken as 0.125 centimeter for the determination of K. So if P is a pressure sustained in kg per cm square by the rigid plate of diameter 75 centimeter. So at a deflection at the deflection, delta is equal to 0.125. Then it is given by k is equal to p by delta is equal to p by 0.125. So unit is kg per cm cube. So next one, put to first or radius of relative stiffness slab to subgrade. Okay, a certain degree of resistance to slab deflection is offered by the subgrade. So the tendency of the slab to deflect is dependent upon its flexural strength. So which depends upon its thickness and strength characteristics of the pavement slab. So the relative stiffness, so this relative stiffness of the slab with respect to the subgrade support is depend upon the properties of slab and pressure deformation characteristics of the subgrade material. So Westergaard's is defined this term as the radius of relative stiffness. So here L, which is expressed by the equation, so L is equal to 4 square root of E into H cube divided by 12 into K into 1 minus mu square. Okay, or E into H cube 12 into K 1 minus mu square root to the power 1 by 4. So here, so L is equal to radius of relative stiffness and H is equal to slab thickness and E is equal to modulus of elasticity of cement concrete in terms of kg per cm square. So in the problem, if it is not given, so we have to consider this 3 into 10 raised to 5. So mu is equal to Poisson's ratio of concrete, so that is 0.15, so we have to consider, and k is equal to subgrade modulus or modulus of subgrade reaction, so that is in terms of kg per cm square. Okay, so in order to use this formula, so they have given one example problem. So compute the radius of relative stiffness of 15 centimeter thick cement concrete slab using the following data. Okay, so let's see what are the data given. Modulus of elasticity of CC 2.1 into 10 raised to 5 kg per cm square is given. Poisson ratio is given 0.15, and the subgrade value, so modulus of subgrade reaction. So they have given two modulus of subgrade reaction given. So for these two, so we have to calculate radius of relative stiffness. So that means L. Okay, so first step one, first we have to write down the given data. So mu is given, K1, K2, and H slab thickness is given, and modulus of elasticity of cement concrete is given. Okay. In step two, so first for K1, 3 kg per cm cube. Okay, so write down the formula. So L is equal to E into H cube divided by 12 K 1 minus mu square to the power 1 by 4. So substitute all the values in this formula and get the answer for this L. So for K1, L is equal to 67.0 centimeter. And similarly for K2, substitute the values and get the answer. For K2 values, L value is equal to 53.3 centimeter. So it may be noted here that the influence of modulus subgrade reaction on the radius of relative stiffness of the slab is relatively small if you compare these two answers. Okay, next one more important concept, equivalent radius of resisting section. So if you see this figure, so there are three critical positions of loading. So considering the case of interior loading, so this one, the maximum bending moment occurs at the loaded area and acts radially in all the direction acts radially in all the directions. So with the load concentrated on a small area of the pavement, the question arises. So as what sectional area of the pavement is effective in resisting the bending moment? According to Westergaard's, the pavement is effective in resisting the bending moment. The equivalent radius of resisting section is approximated in terms of radius of load distribution and slab thickness. To calculate that resisting section, so Westergaard is given this equation, B is equal to square root of 1.6 A square plus H square. So this square root is limited up to this H square minus 0.675 H. So we have to use one condition. So if A, so here A is a radius of wheel, is less than 1.724 H, so then we have to use this equation. Otherwise, so we have to consider B is equal to A, equal to A. So carefully, so we have to use this condition. So in the given problem, we have to verify this condition. So where the radius, A is equal to radius of wheel and H is equal to slab thickness. So we'll see on the example problem. So compute the equivalent radius of resisting section of 20 centimeter thick slab. So given that the radius of contact area field load is 15 centimeter. So solution, step 1, write down the given data. H slab thickness is given and radius of wheel is given. So step 2, first we have to check. So as mentioned in the theory, so we have to check. So A by H is equal to 15 divided by 20 is equal to 0.75. So which is less than 1.724, right? Okay. So therefore, so we have to use this B equation to calculate B. We have to use this equation. So otherwise, if it is less than, so directly we can take the AB is equal to A value. Okay. Substitute the values in this equation, get the B value. So one more three star concept, critical positions of loading. Okay, so in this figure you can see the critical positions of loadings. So there are three critical positions of loading: edge load, interior load and corner load. So this is slab. So in this slab, so these are the critical position load are acting on this slab. So since this pavement slab has a finite length and width, isn't it? Finite length and width. Okay, so either the character or intensity of maximum stress induced by the application of wheel load is dependent on the position or location of the load on the pavement slab. Are you getting this point? Okay. The character or intensity of maximum stress induced on this slab by the application of a given wheel load is dependent on the position or location of the load on the pavement slab. Okay, so three typical positions, so namely interior edge and corner, considered by Westergaard. So with reference to this continuity of rigid pavement slab, so these termed as critical position load or critical load positions. So when the load is applied in the interior, so consider the interior, when the load is applied in the interior of the slab surface at any place remote from all edges, it is called interior loading. So when the load is applied on the edge, so this one, let's at any place remote from all corner, so it is called edge loading. So when the center load of the load applied is located bisector of the corner angle formed by two intersecting edges of the slab. So here you can see two intersecting edges of the slab, and the loaded area is at the corner touching the two corner edges. It is called corner loading. So next, so one more important concept, stresses due to V load, stresses due to V load. Okay, so in this Westergaard's theoretical analysis of stresses in rigid pavement, cement concrete slab is assumed to be homogeneous. So we know that some assumptions, and a thin elastic plate with subgrade reaction being vertical and proportional to the deflection. So Westergaard equations for stress due to V load applied at the three critical locations of interior edge and corner are given below. So you can see the load stress Si due to the interior load, this is the formula, and load stress Sc due to corner load, and load stress is due to the edge loading. So where Si, Se and Sc is the maximum stress at interior edge and the corner region, and H is equal to slab thickness, P is V load, A radius, and L is the radius relative stiffness, B is the radius of resisting section. Okay, let's see the example problem. So using the data given below, calculate the V load stress at interior edge and corner regions of the cement concrete pavement using Westergaard's equations. Also determine the probable location where crack is likely to develop into the corner loading. So then let's see the data given. Given data, the wheel load P is given 5100 kg, modulus of elastic cement is given, H is slab thickness, Poisson ratio, modulus of subgrade reaction, and radius of contact area. So solution, write down all the given datas. Step 2. Okay, so if you observe in this equations, so we required L and B. So radius of relative stiffness and the L modulus of radius of relative stiffness and resisting section, L and B is required. Okay, so second step 2, radius of relative stiffness, L we have to calculate. So by using this equation, so substitute all the values and get L. Okay, step 3, the second one, equivalent radius of resisting section B we have to calculate. So before calculating the B, we have to check this condition. Okay, so A is given and H is given, so calculate 15 divided by 18, so that is 0.833. so as per the condition, which is less than 1.724, so we have to use this equation to calculate B. Okay, substitute all the values and get the B value, so that is 14. So next, directly we can use the equations. So interior load stress Si, by using this calculate, so interior loading stress is 19.3, and similarly edge region 28.54, and corner load and AC 24.2. okay, so in this problem they asked about also determine the probable location where crack is likely to develop due to corner loading. So one more important point, so to calculate this, so we have to use this equation, x is equal to 2.5 2 to the square root a into l. Okay, why you have to use due to corner loading? Tensile stress is developed on the top of the pavement across the corner bisector or the diagonal. So if the corner load stress exceeds the flexural strength of the CC slab, a crack is likely to develop across the diagonal. Okay, across the
diagonal.
Right.
The magnitude stress produced by a wheel load at a corner does not exist around the load. So that is does not exist around the load. Okay, but it occurs at some x distance. Then what is that x distance along the diagonal distance? To calculate this distance, we have to use this equation. So that is x is equal to 83.96.